What are you gonna do?
We're not gonna take out a private army on the ground, Ron. You gotta meet them in the air.
Okay, well, look, I knew that you were pissed after the Meriwether heist, giving back the hardware.
That was bullshit!
Right, right. So I've been monitoring chatter, tapping into Meriwether networks.
Feels good to be back in the company of a professional.
I was expecting something a little more impressive. The late, great Michael Townley.
Not... and not so great, right? And no longer called Townley. The years have not been terribly kind.
What's the end game, man? We had a good thing going without him.
If it's such a good thing, where's my money, huh? Where's my consultancy and my big fat dividend? I want a franchise network, Ron. I want reward cards, merchandise. I want to make gun violence and drug dependency accessible to every man and beast, from Hove Beach to Vespucci. I want country clubs and a depressed wife, blonde hair, and a hot little secretary who bounces on my boy.
There's Oscar's business. That's bringing cash in.
My stake in Oscar's thing ain't under the TP conglomerate umbrella. I want my own brand success.
It takes time!
Time and money! Sure! Just the plane I need to take on a heavily armed, tax-funded militia! Get in touch with my Mexican contact. Tell him we got some guns to sell.
I'll get you on the radio.
Aware of. Enough! You know Ronald. Ronald, you there?
Got a drop, man. They're on their screens.
In a 1989 crop duster, just enjoying the beautiful San Andreas weather.
Unidentified aircraft, divert your course or we will be forced to shoot you down.
Shoot me down? Now that's not very sociable. Change of destination. We are now landing in Mackenzie Field. Swapping radio channels. Over. Ronnie, the cargo jet is now part of the TP Enterprise fleet. You with the Mac?
Thank you.
could diddle yourself! Ron, I've got the fucking Air Force on me!
They deploy jets! Try and fly over them, T!
We'll see in bad health!
Any offensive action will be met with overwhelming retaliation!
I'm landing at McKenzie Field! We can discuss this there, on the dirt, like men!
Trevor! Shit, are you okay? I saw the plane go down.
I survived, and Lizard Army didn't do so well, so that's something.
Ah, thank God! The fuselage went into the Alamo Sea. You might be able to salvage the hardware with dive gear or something.
Good idea! But it'll take time. Tell Oscar he ain't getting these guns.
Okay, look, I gotta ask. Are you in with the federal government? An agent, Sanchez, was round here saying you and Michael had to meet his supervisors at the garage, the cook site.
Fuck, I gotta do this, okay? But I'm using them, all right? They ain't using me. Let's make that clear.
Ah! Uh-huh. hopped up on some happy pills in order to stop another outburst. Ooh.
I call this paradise.
Hi.
Смотреться, вина есть во всем.
Smell any funny spices?
Я ничего не вижу, босс.
Эй, предъяви документы.
What?
Паспорт давай, ебарь, мам.
I don't fucking understand you.
А, да ты по-английски не шаришь? Что за хуйня с тобой? Я говорю, паспорт покажи. Все вы нелегалы как один. Ты по гражданским арестам, ты понял? Америка — страна возможностей. А я воспользуюсь возможностью послать тебя обратно через границу, откуда ты приперся. What?
Very good, Joseph. Real fine. We'll make a civilian protector of our nation's borders from undesirable elements of you yet. Sorry, citizen, just a training exercise.
Ah, okay. Well, I'm so glad that you patriots are out here defending this fine American desert sand.
Well, thank you.
When you could be in town fucking some girls and further destroying the gene pool.
Hey. There's a real problem here.
Да, люди, мотивированные необходимостью прокормить свои семьи, едут сюда работать по черному за копейки и прут в эту страну.
It's a disaster. And that's why we form the Civil Border Patrol. Wait. My Patriot meter's going off. Huh? Come on, both of you. We've got some illegals over them hills. Come on, you drive. You drive, let's go. Drive, get in the back.
Meshkin Offen.
What's your name, citizen?
I'm Joe, that there's Joseph.
Trevor.
Okay, Trevor. Well, it's saying we need to head for the Yellow Jack Inn.
Oh, good. They love me in there.
I'm definitely getting a strong reading. The Patriot meter predicts undesirables with up to 79% accuracy.
Surely this is a sick joke. I mean, I love hanging with freaks, but you two losers cannot be for real.
Unfortunately, this is as real as it gets. These people are criminals who threaten our way of life and drive down our property prices.
Они думают, что могут приехать сюда в поисках лучшей жизни для себя и своей семьи. Это противоречит Конституции.
Come one, come all, I say. This country's got bigger problems to deal with.
Well, that's because you've been brainwashed by the secular media. Don't you worry, though, we'll convert you. My brother showed some, let's just call it sexual weakness in his younger days. But now he's a happily married man with three children, and he rarely acts out. Well, they must be inside. Go see if you can flush them out, Trevor.
Is there any place in the world I'd rather be than drunk as a skunk at the Alamo Sea? I said to the white bitch, I'm going out for a snack.
Hey, you're banned.
Oh, this is pointless. Everyone in here has done something illegal.
How is everything? God, I just got a beautiful leather jacket from Fufu as a gift from a nice lady in the community.
Hey, Trevor, get out here now! They're in that car! Let's go!
How are you?
Not bad. I'm going into my
car. Go! Go! Let's bring him in, boys! Here, take the stun gun!
Really?
Nobody needs to die here. We're civilized people. Can you believe they're singing? It's like they don't even care. You can keep yourself to a style of revolution and discontent.
Well, you
to
sure
yourself.
Didn't.
Hold on to your pointed hat. We're taking the scenic route.
They're on to them sounds.
Sounds like they're having a lot more fun in their car.
Well, look at them, drunk out of their minds on Uncle Sam's dime.
Перед население страны осквернение коренного населения. Это не по-американски.
Hey, I ain't being zealous about this. America is for Americans, and that's why they call it, yeah, you know, America!
Yeah, apart from young Joseph. Apart from young Joseph here.
А я единственный, кто думает, что этот идиот звучит как канадец.
Yeah, that's right, what he said. At least Joseph here wants to be Americanized. You don't see him dressed up like some little sissy bullfighter now, do you? No!
You might want to tell him not to salute with a straight arm.
Что за чёрт?
Look, now's our chance. Go subdue those illegals, Trevor. I want to see how you handle that stun gun.
Стой, Венч!
Я знал, что это была ошибка.
Dios mío!
Sorry about that, pal.
Don't apologize to them. They're the ones breaking the law here. Oh, very nice, Trevor. Respectful, but firm. We can handle it from here. Get in the vehicle. You've had your fun. It's time to go home.
Okay, okay. I do what you say. Mi chance, pendejo. Please, no more! I go with you!
Don't tell me we got ourselves a sympathizer. Well, thanks for the help, citizen. America's a little bit safer because of you.
Little one.
So, big favor. Can you take me to the top of Vinewood Hills by the sign? Thanks, this is so sweet of you. I was starting to think no one was going to stop. Short dress, boots, vulnerable but playful demeanor. What more does a girl have to do these days? You cast out this kind of bait, you'd expect at least a couple of old sharks to come sniffing. But along you came. Thank God.
Less of the old, please. I'm in the prime of my life.
Just promise me you're not going to wear my skin or imprison me in a crawl space for 20 years. Joke. Kind of. You're cool, right? Sorry, I'm coming down. I've been partying like a biatch. Yesterday was a blizzard, man. I don't even remember getting out of bed, let alone going to bed. Good times.
Okay. And what's on top of the Vinewood Hills?
I'm going to see my man.
Guess it's Coyote for dinner.
He's a security guard at the broadcast tower right behind the famous Vinewood sign. He's been stressed out, really working long hours, so I thought I'd surprise the big lug. We haven't seen each other for like a week. Or maybe it's two. I don't know. Crazy how time flies. Wait, that's my phone. Speak of the devil. Hey, sweetie, I was just talking about you. To this guy who was nice enough to give me a ride. No, not like that. I'm pitching back into town. Yeah, I know what happened last time, but I'm pretty sure this guy is okay. I ran out of money or I would have gotten a cab. Yes, all the thousand you gave me. What's the big deal? I said I'd pay you back. I'm sorry, okay? My phone was out of juice. I only just got it charged. I was staying at a friend's at Sandy Shores. You know, Brianna or Susie. No, I haven't spoken to him in weeks. This is just some random guy, I swear. Calm down, babe. Look, would you tell him?
Are you talking to me?
Yes, tell him you're not a guy called Brian. You're just some random guy.
What?
Just shout it.
I'm just some random guy not called Brian.
There, babe, you believe me now? Babe. Babe! Shit, he hung up on me. Sorry about that.
So, on a scale of 1 to 10, how well do you think that went?
He'll be fine when I surprise him. Probably just having a bad day. He can never stay mad at me for long. Opposites attract, you know. He's the serious, responsible, pay your bills, save for the future type, and I'm the sexy, bohemian, go off for days and do X in the middle of the desert type. I'm young. I'm still exploring my mind, discovering who I am. He knows I'll come back.
When you run out of money.
Whoa there, random guy. Less of the judging. Wait, there's my phone again. What's up? Yeah, hitching back into town. Oh my God! Oh no! No way. God damn it! Oh my God! What's going on? Oh no! This is weird. Oh my God!
Well, I'll be fucked.
What a douchebag!
Thank you. Oh, nice place you got here.
Oh, yeah, it's easy to mock, isn't it, huh? Cheap and fucking easy. But this here is my place. And my work paid for my place.
All right, relax. I was just being sarcastic.
Yeah, well, don't be, all right? Because the world doesn't need any more sarcasm. It's the blight of the age.
Yeah, I get the point.
You don't get the point. You're like every other asshole. You made a bit of money, and you became a turd.
Got news for you. I was always a turd.
No! You weren't, man. You were something. But now, man, you know, you're like this place. You're a shell.
Go fuck yourself. Are you some kind of pure morally justifiable asshole? What, because you're totally psychotic, somehow it's okay?
I'm honest, all right? You're the hypocrite.
Oh, yeah, you're a fucking hero. So far above it all.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'm not above ripping open your fucking chest to see what's replaced your heart.
Rip it open! See what's there, baby, because I'm ready.
Hello? Oh, ladies, what's up?
Fuck off!
Listen, I'm sorry, but we've got a problem. Government funding thing. We need you to investigate a research lab upstate.
It's about terrorism, the big one, nerve gas, biological terror.
Thank God I don't pay tax.
Listen, you'll need some fairly standard gear. A boat, tandem rotor heavy lift helicopter, truck, weapons. You'll have to source all of that. Chopper alone will set you back a couple of mil.
Oh, no worries there. Trevor here, he just came into a lot of money.
Is that sarcasm?
Oh, you're fucking A right at sarcasm. You fuck. A few weeks ago, I was happily retired, sulking by my swimming pool. My psychotic best friend shows up out of nowhere to torture me over mistakes I made, honest mistakes I made over a decade ago. We, our little posse, are flat fucking broke. But hey, let's go out and spend $2 million on a tandem rotor fucking chopper so I can go steal nerve gas from fucking terrorists. Forgive me, you ignorant fuck. But sarcasm is all I fucking got. Sarcasm! And a room full of you cunts!
Yes! Woo! Welcome back, man. It is the old you.
Yeah. Well, we gotta go. It's been great, but Dave here's got a Pilates class. Now remember, ladies, you keep us way out of this thing. Bye-bye.
Ah, Jesus fucking Christ. All right, I'll give Lester a fucking call. He said he knew about something.
Now you tell him that we're driving towards Polito Bay.
Come on, you're driving us up to the bank.
What now? We got a funding problem, so we need a job. Before the jewel store, you talked about a score, a bank in the sticks. I need you to meet us there. Polito Bay, right?
That's the one. I'll get on a bus.
I did everything to make you happy. All right, Lester's meeting us there. Don't start.
I won't. No way. Good call. If you're taking down a bank for a few million, first thing you do is call the hospital, tell them to get you a guy in a wheelchair.
Oh, this Hayseed Bank, you gonna be carrying that kind of change?
Local law enforcement extort money from all the weed farms, whorehouses, meth kitchens in the area. They keep their cash in safe deposit boxes. Then there's all the normal small town payroll stuff.
We should do well. You know, I've been thinking about you, Trevor. Your lifestyle.
Oh, have you? Really?
Yes, I have. People always try to label you, you know? Maniac, psycho,
friend, industry leader.
In some ways, you defy categorization. But then,
what?
Think about it. Where you live.
Sandy Shores, you precious ass. I'm sorry there ain't a place nearby for you to get your colonics.
Right. But why are you out here?
It's off the grid. We're away from it all. It's somewhere real and authentic. This is America! And real people ain't been priced out yet.
Yeah, well, what if it gets gentrified?
Then I'll fucking move.
Okay. What about the way you dress?
What about it? I don't give a shit what I wear.
No. If you don't give a shit, you wear clean clothes that fit. So yours are all a little out there, you know, a little wacky.
Whatever's in the shop is what I get. Jesus, what is this?
It's not an absence of taste, T. It's the opposite of taste.
You should be a stylist.
And then there's the tattoos, the hair, the weird music, the funny toys, the niche drugs, the everything.
What the fuck are we talking about?
You are a hipster.
What?
You're a hipster.
I hate hipsters.
Classic hipster denial.
I abhor hipsters. I eat them for fun.
Hipsters love saying they hate hipsters.
Well, I really fucking do.
Self-hatred, common hipster affliction.
It'll be because I'm living out here away from the bean machines and the bankers.
You're gentrifying. Soon, the skinny jeans will show up.
The bus stops up here.
All right. How long does it take us to get out here from LS?
Come on, man, knock it off.
What?
I'm gonna break your fucking fingers, you don't knock that shit off.
Well, please, all right? You'd alleviate the boredom.
Ah, finally. Hey.
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 Welcome to paradise. Come on, car's this way.
Dry out here.
Don't worry, brother. Mark will take care of all your moisturizing needs. Oh. Shall we?
Might as well get started.
Drive us to the bank. And we'll go to the front of the bank, clock the entrance. If the paperwork's correct, the alarm will be a relic. We should be in and out before the local PD knows what's happening. That's the entrance to the bank. Nothing special. Take us around back.
Okay.
There's an empty lot behind. No one should pay attention to us back there.
I like it. Yeah, the place is remote. It's got the right amount of foot traffic. This'll do.
It's not ideal. It's gonna cost more to break that system than the score's gonna pay.
Then we're gonna have to find a new score.
No. This is the score. What are our options?
It's a dumb idea, but we could trigger the alarm. See what kind of response they throw out.
That is a dumb idea.
Hey, you heard the man, all right? Shoot the sucker.
Okay, I brought my police scanner. Now drive over to the gas station opposite the bank, and we'll monitor chatter.
All right.
Frequency, we have a code 30, Adam. Alarm going off at Blaine County Savings Bank. All cars in the area, please respond.
Toledo cars 3, 6, 9, and 1 will be there in 50 seconds.
Roger that. 4 units. Backup team at station is available.
They've dispatched 4 cars in 60 seconds and more on standby. And it isn't even 30 Victor or shots fired. Oh, this is a real headache.
What do you got on the clock?
40 seconds.
This is Toledo Security. Any updates on the code 30, Adam? Backup ready to mobilize.
This is not normal. The response is out of proportion.
cops in this county are dirty. The alarm just went off on their piggy bank.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Trying to get high.
You for real?
What's my trouble?
This is them. What is that, a 67-second response time?
Yeah, four cars, more in the wings.
Bad cops, guarding dirty money. Fuck how many? We can take this.
Wait right here. We'll see if anything about their routine suggests a weakness.
Polito Radio, this is Polito Car 3. We have a code 12, false alarm, possibly triggered intentionally.
Roger that. We're gonna set up checkpoints on the Great Ocean Highway and the Sonora Freeway. Car-to-car searches and record checks.
Checkpoints? Searches? Fuck this! I ain't getting caught because Lester needs a wheelchair.
Hey! Wheelchair or not, we're still faster than your ass!
Are you hurt?
Thank you.
Mexican Institute of Sound.
And you're listening to Islos FM.
What took you so long?
What took you so long?
Set up a board over here.
Oh. Michael, man, your blood sugars are low. I'm making you some leftovers.
I'm fine, T.
Huh? No, I'm the host, man. You know, I don't want you to get hungry and moody, right? Then you're gonna be making the wrong decisions.
Man, I've been making wrong decisions my whole life. That's how I ended up here.
Yo, bon appetito.
Jesus Christ, Trevor, what is that?
What's wrong with you? That's just a what? An eyelid. It's probably not even human. Unless that gas station job.
Gentlemen, some plans for your attention?
Good. I'm gonna stay here a minute longer than I have to.
So I think our little experiment showed that the response will be too quick to beat and too strong to walk through. That means you gotta face the cops head on.
Dirty cops?
The dirty cops head on.
Head on? Man, I don't know.
Well, you'll be prepared. Convoys carrying military-grade hardware pass near here to get to Fort Zancudo. I propose hijacking one and using the equipment to get an edge on the locals. I can get you the exact details of the shipment as soon as we're done here. Anyway, you won't be outside the bank too long. Polito Bay is, well, it's a bay. So you're a street away from the water where Franklin can be waiting in a boat to get you out of there. I know none of this is ideal, but it's the only way I can see of taking the score and providing for your FIB paymasters.
Fine. We need personnel?
Just a gunman. He'll be taking on the cops with you, so my advice, choose someone good.
Think about my buddy Chef, okay? Consummate professional.
That it? You sure?
That should do.
I'll get the equipment together. Michael, you reach out to Franklin. Trevor, you do what you do.
Roger that.
I'll call you when we're ready to move on this.
You want to bunk with us? I mean, it's gonna be tight, but, you know, mi casa, su casa.
I'll get a motel, thanks.
All right, treat yourself.
Come on, I'll give you a ride.
Okay. Adios, amigos. Franklin, buddy, what's up?
Hey, look, there's these redneck dudes been looking for you, homie. Some angry motherfuckers. I found where they stay, man, and I've been following them.
Okay, well, it's gotta be the O'Neill brothers.